Vasuji, I believe you are missing the key word there.
Okay.
What I have also written is unwittingly.
Unwittingly, okay.
Yeah, I think one should grant him this benefit of doubt.
Okay.
He just knew into the position, and I think without realizing what he was getting into, he has ended up endorsing this narrative which was being built over the last 4.5 years. I must say, this was being built during our Congress regime, only under Captain Amarinder Singh Ji's leadership, that we have a clear and present danger from across the border.
Right.
But I think nobody within the party or within the state subscribed to it. Me being part of that, that I never subscribed to this, and I thought this was only some kind of, I don't know, whatever the motive might have been. But on the ground, this is far from the truth. There is no such apprehension on the ground. I don't know what is the intelligence input which CM Saab had access to,
okay,
or what access Amit Shah Ji has. But on the ground, there's nothing to indicate that there's any increased threat. Of recent, I think, of, if you look at his recent tweets, Captain Saab has mentioned about the Afghanistan pullback of America out of there, and this will increase the threat.
Right.
I think it would be foolish on our part, part of India, to underestimate the threat from ISI. Their entire existence of the Pakistan army and their astronomical spending is based upon portraying India as a threat, and to keep that threat perception alive, I think they will always keep creating problems.
Okay. No, no. So let me understand what you're saying then. Are you saying that while there may be a threat, there is no need to have gone and taken this decision to give the BSF that much remit of 50 kilometers?
Yes, precisely. This threat is nothing new, Vasuji, but I'm saying.
Okay, you're saying there's nothing new.
Nothing new. This has been here since 1947.
Okay, but one thing.
It's going to continue.
Okay, but one thing with all respect, Chakkar Saab, is that this yet again seems to have become an instance where the Congress is speaking in a divided way. Mr. Channi has come out and attacked it. You are also saying that there was no need for this. But Captain Amarinder is defending it. He's saying we're seeing more and more weapons and drugs being pushed by Pak-based terrorists into Punjab. BSF's enhanced presence and powers will only make us stronger.
Let's take Captain Saab's statement on his face value. Does that mean that we put our Punjab under central rule? If BSF makes us stronger, then why don't we invite our army? Why don't we put army? I think then we'll be much more stronger. These are issues which we have been tackling all along, sir. Drugs and weapons have been smuggled in all along. That's what I'm saying. Nothing is new.
But,